Welcome to the final installment in our Yagan Saga. First, we looked at the events that led up to the creation of the martial art. Then we looked at how well Josie was able to demonstrate Yagan techniques in Tekken 7. Finally, in this video, we will compare and contrast some of Josie Yagan attacks with other kickboxers from other games. We'll then recommend some new attacks and recommend some additional resources if you're interested in learning more about Yagan. I'm the Unknown Fang. And welcome to my channel. The new fighters we will look at are King from the Art of Fighting and KOF series. She's an extremely gifted kickboxer with a really unique style, heavily centered around kicks. And while I almost went for Joe Higashi, I think that King is a much more interesting pick. Pinoy kickboxer laced up in hand and leg wraps. His backstory in Def Jam was that of a prize fighter far too brutal for the regular circuits. What makes him really unique is that he's probably one of the first Yagan fighters to make a video game appearance. The Calypso kickboxer has a lot of flashy spinning kicks. Much like his music, his fighting style is all about the freedom of expression. Sagat was my first choice. Personally, I think DJ is a far more entertaining character. It's nice to see a kickboxer that isn't afraid to loosen up. Even though Brad uses a fighting style based around Muay Thai, you can see a lot of influence from boxing. As most of you can tell from the Kudo series, he's here because I'm in love with the animation style that Sega uses in Virtual Fighter. No matter how many times you can replace him, Bruce has a certain appeal that most Tekken players cannot deny. Since Tekken 2, the pioneer of Muay Thai kickboxing has been replaced at least 3 times, first by Brian, then Josie, and finally the new kid on the block. In his first game trailer, we thought it was the return of Bruce, but instead we got a Muay Baran fighter bringing the lightning and thunder. Guys, thank you for tuning in, and let's get started. When I think of elbow attacks, I think of the club, sword, or spear. While most martial arts do have elbows in them, kickboxing and mixed martial arts is where you can truly see their destructive power. Whether by a smashing knockout or a slashing cut, the elbow is deeply respected. And while it is technically a close range attack, it can be deployed from a variety of different ranges. King has kicks for days and seems to prefer them. However, she does have one elbow in an extremely close range, and it comes in handy as it is one of her faster attacks. It takes a lot of guts to bring Filipino kickboxing into the shoot fighting arena, but Santos is able to hold his own quite well. He doesn't have a lot of elbow attacks, but he's able to make do with what he has. His elbows come from the clinch, from the outside, and even from short combinations ending with a reverse elbow. The only unconventional elbow I can think of would be his elbow drop, which is more commonly seen in professional wrestling. DJ attacks with a reverse elbow that combos into a right straight, taking away a decent chunk of damage. DJ uses what is referred to as a Sukwan clock or reverse elbow from the Ong Bak movie, made even more famous by Anderson Silva. He now has two different variations of the infamously banned 12-6 downward elbow. Back in the realm of 3D, Brad Burns has a huge amount of elbow attacks. He can set up his elbow strikes through combinations or come directly at his opponent from a variety of different angles. Horizontal, diagonal, vertical, and reverse slashes are all part of Brad's attack plan. Some of them include jumping, while others are delivered from the clinch. His most dynamic one has got to be his spinning elbow finisher from his wall combo. Even though he has been replaced by Josie, the New Yorker also has a huge amount of elbows that he can use, and they are fast. He even has one combination strictly dedicated to a trio of elbows. He can strike from the ground, air, or straight on, but he really shows his strength in the clinch. Many of Josie's elbows were built up from Bruce's original attacks. The only other fighter dangerous in a clinch with his elbows has to be the latest kickboxer from Thailand. He does have a few setups from the outside, but once he grabs you, he will smash and slice you apart. With a jab and cross coming straight ahead and the hook curving around, the uppercut is a strike that sneaks in from below. Sometimes it's used to set up for a more powerful strike, other times it hits hard enough to finish the job all by itself. A King's uppercut is exaggerated and resembles the European uppercut more often seen in pro wrestling. Her other uppercut comes after a knee and sends her opponent flying back. Santos makes great use of the clinch by punching his opponent from the inside, and you can actually see how damaging these punches are by how far the opponent's head reels back from each strike. It's safe to say that DJ hasn't mastered the uppercut so well that he's able to create a thin blade of concussive force that that hits his opponent from long distances. During its machine gun upper, his strikes become a blur, and he hits his opponent with multiple strikes, not unlike a piston. You can really see these highlighted during this level 3 Super Rare combo from the Alpha series. However, when he uses his ultra combos, he is a force to be reckoned with. His Sabat Carnival ends with his energy literally manifesting itself as a shadow clone, and as impressive as it seems, that doesn't even hold a candle to his Climax Beat combination. Brad is phenomenal in setting up his uppercuts after a series of punches such as a double jab. His boxing ability really shines from the different ways he hits with the uppercut, and he also has a lot of power behind them, the kind of power that sends you airborne. Bruce moves in with his uppercuts, but they are mainly used to set up other attacks. Tekken 2 was released around the same time as Street Fighter Alpha, and Bruce has had many compare him to Sagat. We'll go more into Sagat's uppercut in the YouTube short, but it's obvious to see just how similar Bruce's Tornado Upper is to Sagat's Tiger Upper. Much like Brad, Falcon ends a few of his combinations with an uppercut that launches his opponents airborne, while he's able to close the distance with a vicious uppercut. In fight circles, it's commonly understood that the worst attack to be hit by is the one you don't see coming. Imagine you're in a fight with your opponent, you see them turn, and you're ready to move in for the kill, then the ref is standing over you, counting you out. Unfortunately for you, you are the latest victim to Rokas. King has a few punches, but no spinning back fist. As the only Filipino kickboxer, Santos definitely has a spinning back fist in his pocket. He has a quite unorthodox way of employing it, but he's definitely confident enough to use it. Much like King, DJ doesn't have any spinning back fist, and Brad also lacks a spinning back fist. As Josie's potential instructor, if the writers ever pull their heads out of their Bruce has a spinning back fist identical to Josie's. Fuckerum uses a spinning back fist to finish many of his combos. They come with a lot of power, and after hitting his opponent, they naturally crumble to the ground. While sometimes confused with the sidekick, a downward facing knee is a dead giveaway of a back kick. It goes without saying that the sidekick does have speed on its side, but the back kick has more power. Turn that into a spinning back kick and you have a huge amount of torque and power focused on one small area of impact, leading to catastrophic results. As an advanced agile kicking machine, King doesn't settle for any measly back kick. Instead, she has a powerful jumping spinning back kick that sends her opponent flying back. Santos doesn't use a spinning back kick in the fight for New York, but since he probably knows Yoyan, I'm sure he just chooses not to use it. DJ makes extensive use of the back kick. His double rolling Sabat kick combines a jumping roundhouse with a spinning back kick. Brad is able to hit his opponent using two different back kicks. Bruce has a similar combination to DJ's with a spinning roundhouse followed by a spinning back kick. Now Falcon has a few spinning back kicks quite similar to Bruce's and Josie's. One area where he stands out is the ability to chamber his kick longer and deliver a guard-breaking back kick. Not everyone can deliver this type of roundhouse. However, it can lead to some excellent results, and sometimes it's better to live by the phrase, go hard or go home. King is the king of kicks and really shines in this area. Her venom strike is so fast that she sends a vacuum of pure concussive force through the air towards her opponent. She also uses a jumping roundhouse kick in her tornado kick special move, which is similar to the jackknife in tricking. Finally, she goes all out with her illusion dance desperation move, throwing everything in her arsenal at the player and ending with a jumping spinning left. As a shoot fighter, Santos prefers to keep his roundhouse kicks grounded. On the other hand, DJ's jumping roundhouse looks the same as King's. While his energy projectiles come from his uppercuts, his jackknife maximum is more designed to catch airborne opponents. Much like the Penguin, Brad is also forced to stand there while many of his kickboxing peers fly. Bruce also ports legs firmly planted on the ground when delivering his tree chopping kicks. Fuckrum delivers a no-nonsense roundhouse. There's no spin, and its main goal is covering distance. After jumping for it with a knee, he delivers a roundhouse with his right leg. The roundhouse kick has solidified its place in many disciplines. There are many different variations, and targets can be anywhere on the body from head to toe. Some martial arts believe in snapping the leg, while others stress a full swing of the entire leg. With Yoyan, a huge amount of emphasis is placed on turning their hips at the last moment. King's feud with Joe Higashi is legendary. Joe's powers are in his knees and uppercuts. The King is the King of Kicks. Her kicks strike opponents from nearly every level, and she's able to use multiple strikes to give Chun-Li a run for her money. She's also acrobatic, and after a backflip, she can unleash her trap shot, sending her opponents airborne. Santos' roundhouses are limited but practical. He can hit grounded opponents as well as attack their legs while in the clinch. He can also deliver a pair of head kicks from each leg. DJ hits with low and mid snapping roundhouses, but some of his moves include a spinning right roundhouse. When he's really feeling the rhythm of the night, DJ backflips and unleashes a legion of devastating kicks. The roundhouse kicks from Brad usually come with combinations. He finishes many of them with low kicks, but he can also use an alarming amount of decapitating head kicks as well. And unlike Santos, Brad is able to hit his opponent anywhere in any way he wants to, whether striking low or high or even using a flurry of kicks. Brad is a talented striker with the ability to change the angles of his attacks. Bruce is no slouch when it comes to the roundhouses. Like Brad, he's able to effectively change his attack patterns, making him unpredictable and difficult to defend against. Bruce can also combo into his roundhouse kicks, hitting low and then high, or vice versa. He's also able to combine his punches and knees with different attack patterns. Fulcrum combos into his roundhouse kicks. From teeps to knees, he can end with a low or high roundhouse kick. One unique attack is his kick reversal, where after countering, he goes to the body a few times and finishes with a head kick. The Mountain Storm kick is the pride and joy of Yoyan fighters. The twist of the hip and downward strike really shows the amount of power behind it. King is a phenomenal kicker, but she doesn't have any attacks that resemble a Mountain Storm or even question mark kick. Santos delivers a Mountain Storm to his opponent's leg. While the target is not high, it doesn't have to be, as the lower the kick travels, the more momentum and potential damage it builds up. Known in Capoeira as the Haish, DJ's Sabad Carnival move begins with a flurry of round kicks and jackknives but ends with the Haish, which is an inverted kick known for opening the hips to deliver a downward striking roundhouse. Brad does have a lot of hard-hitting roundhouses, but none of them resemble a Mountain Storm kick. Now imagine fighting your opponent and he goes down. Sand touches the ground and your killer instincts kick in. Before you know it, his instep, if you're lucky, or lower shin slams into your temple. Your eyes open as the referee is standing over you waving his arms. This is a Manamkalo, or horse kick. This is an inverted cartwheel kick, and both Bruce and Fulcrum use this attack. But Fulcrum also has a large amount of question mark kicks from both legs. From up close or far away, driving your knee into your opponent's skull rocks them to sleep. It's not always easy to pull off, but when the hard bones of the knee and skull meet, it's time for bed. King doesn't use her jumping knees for power. She has two that are used for starters for her special and desperation move. Santos has one jumping knee where he jumps onto his opponent's back and rides them face first into the ground. It's not really a strike, but more of a grappling move. And DJ has one jumping knee. There isn't much power behind it, and its main use seems to be for moving in for an additional attack. Finishing his combination with a double knee matches Brad's flashy style. He even shows his agility and athleticism by jumping off the wall. He can also deliver a rising knee quite similar to Paul's mountain raise. And finally, he can drop a knee onto a grounded opponent, not unlike Tony Jaa in Ambak. Bruce is extremely adept in delivering jumping knees. He can finish combinations with jumping knees, but he also has a great armament when it comes to single or double knees. While he doesn't have as many knees as Bruce, Fulcrum still has quite a few he can use to knock his opponent out. This can be done from far away, all the way up to grappling attack range. Targets can be directed to the midsection, legs, or even head. As we saw with Josie, she can deliver them from the outside or at the tail end of a combination. King does have a few knees, mostly from her throws and clinches. One of them involves her kneeing the opponent and continuing her motion into a backflip throw. Santos has a few knees from the clinch. One is a brutal knee to his opponent's spine, while the other knee shows up in the middle of one of his kick combinations. DJ doesn't really focus on knees, but he does have a quick light version when the action gets too close. Not happy with just one, Brad has a ton of different knees. One actually comes out of a sway similar to Josie's. A few others come from combinations, but he's also able to take advantage of his Muay Thai clinch. Bruce has a lot of knees to give. He usually ends his combinations with a knee, but he's also able to add a few fakes into his other knees, and few are powerful enough to send his opponents airborne. He's also able to deliver a large amount of knees from the clinch, but one of my favorite knees of Bruce's is this awkward spinning roundhouse knee. Fulcrum has a few knees from this clinch, and he also has a few combinations using knees. Much like his back kick, Fulcrum's knees can be blocked or charged for a more powerful devastating hit that breaks the opponent's guard. Bruce has a huge amount of elbows, but I'm actually a fan of the Bradshaw. He has an arsenal of different elbows with really nice animation, which is why I think Brad has the best elbows. DJ was born to deliver uppercuts. From his projectiles to his machine gun uppers, no other kickboxer comes close to this level of mastery with damaging uppercuts. Because of his clinch work, Bruce Irving is the king of knees. Fulcrum does have a lot of knees, and he does have a special charge animation, but Bruce's are much more damaging and versatile. Now in regards to the jumping version, I would actually make it a tie between Bruce and Brad. Both display levels of mastery, but Bruce barely edges out Brad because of his damage and juggle ability. Roundhouse kicks definitely go to Fulcrum. While King is the king of kicks, Fulcrum has the range and power that puts him over. His low kicks also display a level of brutality that even Joe Higashi wouldn't dare challenge. And much like DJ, King is able to produce a powerful amount of projectiles from his simple kick. Many of the strongest kicks in our combinations are jumping roundhouses. DJ does challenge her a few times with his jackknife combinations, but she edges out with her increased volume of roundhouses. Fulcrum's question mark kicks are devastating, and he even has an acrobatic horse kick. However, I still like the way that Santos uses his mountain storm kick. It rises very high and buries itself into his opponent's leg, and this will probably lead to disastrous results in real life. Fulcrum takes the top spot for this one, using his spinning backhands. The way they strike the opponent and cause him to crumble into a pile of baby sleep put him over Bruce and Santos. Fulcrum's power to break through guards should be enough to make him the king of back kicks, but DJ reigns supreme in this department. His rolling sabot combinations place him at the top. This combination of two Rokas is the flagship of so many Yeon combinations, and I was really surprised that I didn't see it in any of Josie's combinations. I think that adding this combination to Josie's movesets would really do the martial art justice, but also give her more personality instead of just being a Bruce clone. Yeon is based on unarmed Eskrima strikes. They are more than ready to take on weapons. I think she should be able to use an attack reversal on weapons as well as the right punch. And this could be anything from Yoshi's swords, Negan's bat, Leroy's canes, and Kunimusu's tanto. Technically, her up forward forward is a 540, and she has a few approaching moves with her crouch dash. I think that giving her a mountain storm kick that hits mid and sends her opponent into a tailspin will pay honor to her art as well as give her more variety. Instead of swaying, give her a short hop out of range, similar to Feng Wei's Kenpo step. Yeon is all about being agile, and while it does look cool to see her dodge high kicks and punches, it would be better to see her dodge everything before exploding forward with a flurry of attacks. Leroy has his cane, and I think these item moves may be a part of each character's moveset in future Tekken games. I would have her attack her opponent with the Yonatuk using flashy spins to leave her opponent stunned so she can continue her juggle. This would definitely appease some of the fans that claim that she doesn't know any Eskrima. Yoyan was the dream of one man to design a style of foot fighting strictly for his Filipino people. It was overshadowed by Eskrima, but I actually see it as a continuation. Jose Rizal is a great beacon for this art, and I do wonder how it will continue to evolve in the future. For now, in our next series we will take a trip to two places, the beaches of Copacabana, Brazil, and southern France. We will explore another form of kickboxing from one of the newer Latinas in Tekken. I'll see you all really soon. God bless. Feng Wei. Out.
You have seen some of the textures of Yawiyang. Why not invite the people? You are Filipino, right?